Why should I play the Roman fool and die on mine own sword, whiles I see lives and the gashes do better upon them?
Turn, Alhaut, turn!
Of all men else I have avoided thee, but get thee back, my soul is much too charged with the blood of thine already.
I have no words for thee, my voice is my sword, thou bloodier villain the terms can give thee out.
Thou losest labor, as easy as mayst thou the entrenched air, with thy keen sword impress and make me bleed. Let thy fall vulnerable crest. I bear a charmed life which must not yield to one of woman born.
Despair thy charm, and let the angel whom thou still hast served tell thee, Macduff was from his mother's womb untimely ripped.
Cursed be that tongue that tells me so, for it hath cowed my better part of man, and be these juggling fiends no more believed, that palter with us in a double sense, that keep the word of promise to our ear, and break it to our hope. I'll not fight with thee.
Then yield thee, coward, and live to be the show and gaze of the time. We'll have thee as our rare monsters are, pinned upon a pole, and under it, here may you see the tyrant.
I will not yield to kiss the ground before young Malcolm's feet, and to be baited with the rabble's curse, though Burnham would be come to Dunsinane. Yet I will try the last, before my body I throw my warlike shield, lay on Macduff, and damned be him for the last cries, hold enough.
I would the friends we miss, were safe, arrived.
Some must go off, and yet by these I see, such great a day as this is cheaply bought.
Macduff is missing, and your noble son.
Your son, my lord, has paid a soldier's debt. He only lived but till he was a man. The witcher no sooner had his prowess confirmed in the unshrinking station where he fought, but like a man he died.
Then he is dead?
I am brought off the field. Your cause of sorrow must not be measured by its worth, for then it hath no end.
Had he his hurts before?
Aye, on the front.
Why then, God's soldier be he. Had I as many sons as I have hairs, I would not wish them to a fairer death, and so his knell is knolled.
He's worth more sorrow, and that I'll spend for him.
He's worth no more. They say he parted well and paid his score, and so God be with him. Here comes newer comfort.
King, for so thou art. Behold where stands the usurper's cursed head. The town is free. I see it compass with thy kingdom's pearl. Then speak my salutations to their minds, whose voices I desire loud mine. Hail, King of Scotland!
Hail, King of Scotland!
We shall not spend a large expense of time before we reckon our several loves, and make us even with you. My thanes and kinsmen henceforth be earls, the first time ever Scotland. In what such honor named, what much be due, what would be planted newly with the time. As calling home our exiled friends abroad that fled the snares of watchful tyranny, producing forth the cruel ministers of this death butcher and his friend-like queen, who, as 'tis thought, by self and violent hands, took off her life. This and that needful else that calls upon us by the grace of grace, we will perform in measure, time and place. So thanks to all and once each other, whom we invite to see us crowned at Scone.